Hey guys, Laura here, and today I was really encouraged to do a perfect bridal makeup tutorial because of all the weddings happening this spring. So this is the look, and if you like what you see, then stay tuned. Okay, so the first thing I normally do is have whoever I'm doing the makeup on is moisturized, and the moisturizer I just used is this Aveeno Smart Essentials. And the second thing I have them do is just apply a lip balm. That way by the time we're finished doing the makeup look, that way their lips are really soft and smooth and ready for the lipstick to be applied. So our first step is priming, and I'm going to prime the face using this primer. And it is a silicone based primer, that way it brings out more of a matte finish instead of a shiny finish. So I'm just going to prime the whole entire face, including the eyelids, around the nose, upper lip, and even around the neck area. So next is our foundation, and I'm just going to use CoverGirl's True Blend foundation, and I'll just pump a little bit on my hand, and I'll just use my foundation brush, and I'll work that all the way in a circular motion for more of a flawless finish, and I'll work it in all the way into the hairline, that way there is no harsh makeup lines. A little bit of a heavier makeup look, especially on a wedding day, because of all the pictures that you will be taking. The flashes in the camera are going to bring out what's underneath the makeup really easily. So sometimes you can put on some makeup and take pictures with your friends, but maybe if you have a little bit of redness in your skin or dark spots, they still come out, and that's because of the flash. I am going to go ahead and draw on the eyebrows, and I'm just using my brunette pencil by MAC. And as you can see, they are a bit dark. So what I'm going to do now is just take my eyebrow wand, and I'm just going to brush through them for a more natural appearance. Okay, now that that part's done, next we're going to move on to the eyes. So I took a paint pod in Bare Study by MAC. I just brushed right underneath the brow bone with this color. This is a really pretty, fine grain, shimmery color. I'm just going to use some Urban Decay eyeshadow primer just for the lid. And rub that in. And what I like to do next is just apply a light coat of a foundation powder all over the face and just lightly brush it over the eyelid, because that helps some of the stickiness to get off, and that'll help our eyeshadow blend a little bit better. The foundation powder that I just used is by Color Science, and this is actually a loose powder that has a SPF 30 in it. So, okay, now I'm going to get started with the eyeshadow. So for the perfect wedding day eyeshadow, I found is this color by MAC. It is called Shimmer Time, and it's just a loose pigment that is really shimmery, and it is a light pink color. It's really easy to make a mess with this stuff. But I'm going to start by applying this in the corner of my eye by patting it on, and then I'm going to work it out all over the lid, kind of leaving the end corner with none on it. And if you notice, I'm kind of patting this on. And then I'm going to go right above the brow bone. Once that's done, the palette that I chose to use for this look is the Naked One palette. And I'm just going to use the color Naked. And I'm just going to take a fluffy blending brush and kind of put this in the crease of the eye. And then the next color that I'm going to use is the color Toasted in this palette. It's this kind of rosy color right here. And take just a medium-sized brush, and you'll just tap off the excess. That way you don't get too much on. And then I'm going to work this kind kind of where I work the naked color in the crease and then bring it up. And again, you'll do your makeup just a little bit heavier on your wedding day, therefore the pictures and the flash won't wash out the pretty colors that you used. And for the next color we're gonna use is, is Hustle, which is this one right here, the darker maroon color. And I'm actually gonna just use a little pencil brush and work that into the crease. Take the shimmer time color again and go back over our highlight. So now it's time for eyeliner. You're going to always want to use a waterproof eyeliner for your bride. I'm going to choose Black Track by MAC, and of course that is a waterproof eyeliner. I'm just going to use a really thin eyeliner brush just to get a really precise line. You have your eyeliner, and you can go ahead and top line if you want to do that. Which top lining is going to make your eyelashes appear a whole lot thicker. Now that I've done that, I chose to do the waterline with the color Milk by NYX Jumbo Pencil in a white line. Kind of gives the eyeballs a bigger appearance, or you could just use black if you're more comfortable with that. So you can just go ahead and fill in your waterline with whichever color. So we are going to go ahead and conceal, and I'm just using what I normally use, just my NYX HD Photogenic Concealer under the eyes, down the nose, you can do around your nostrils. I like to go ahead and do the upper lip, and then a little bit on the forehead. Now that we have concealed, we can go ahead and do the bottom eyeshadow. I take this teeny tiny brush, and then I use the color Hustle that we used before. And I like to really lightly pat this on under the eye. We can go ahead and contour our face. For contouring, I'm going to be using Blunt by MAC. I make sure that the color has no shimmer in it, that is a very matted color. And you can even do a little U under the chin to make your bottom lip look a little bit more pouty. And now we're going to do blush. For my brides, I like to do a more simple, kind of light pastel-y blush. I'm going to be using Easy Manner by MAC and an angled blush brush. I kind of like to do the apples of the cheek, so kind of right below your pupils is where you're going to apply your blush. And there we have our blush, and so as you can see, we kind of have built up a couple of harsh lines there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take our loose powder again, and I'm going to kind of sprinkle that all over the face. For a highlight, highlighter, you're going to want to use something with a really fine grain shimmer. If you pick up a highlighter or any type of blush that has lots of larger specks of glitter in it, the flash is going to pick that up and it's going to bring out your face to look like really wide. I don't know if you guys have ever taken a picture or something with somebody and their face was just completely white. That's because the flash is picking up the bigger flakes of shimmer. So, of course, a fine grain shimmer and a really good one is by The Balm, and it is Mary Lou Matinizer. I had the mini one here. I'm just going to use my finger and apply that right above the cheekbone. And you can even apply a little bit down the nose, forehead. You can even do a little bit on the corners of your eyelids and maybe a little on the upper lip. What I like to do for the eyelashes is coat them in a layer of mascara, and then for my brides I like to apply individual lashes instead of just a whole row of fake lashes, because it gives it a more natural appearance. Now we're going to start with our false lashes. So I like the, I think it's called Andrea false lashes. They work really, really well, and they come with the glue. What I like to do is just pour a little bit of the glue out onto a tray, and then it comes with the little pointy tweezers. Start with the bigger ones, which will be the ones down here, and I'll pick them up with the tweezers. I'll put a little bit of glue on the end of it and kind of blow it to dry, and I start from the outer corner and work my way in. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is the lips. I kind of don't like to go too bold on the lips for the wedding day. A lot of times whenever you would do a darker color, if you do black and white pictures, it makes the lips turn out as a black color instead of the color you chose, like a red or something. So I like to go a little bit lighter. So what I've chose is the Go Nude by the Maybelline Color Whispers and the NARS Turkish Delight mixed together. And I just kind of apply this all over like that, and then I put on the Turkish Delight. So another really cool trick you can do for your lips is you can take any shimmery eyeshadow or blush. I'm just going to use a little bit of our Shimmer Time that we used on our eyes and pat it on the lips, which just makes the prettiest, ultimate, shimmery lip color. And there you have our bridal makeup look. I hope you guys enjoyed this look. If you have any questions about anything I use, just comment below. And of course, in the description, I will list every single product that I used for this look. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys. And don't forget to subscribe.